So, hello everyone. I'm here now again in Alsace, France, climbing a hill. It said 50 minutes and I'm really running here up the hill, and I think it's only 10 minutes left and it was half the time. So again, Alsace, and here in this direction, still my hand here, in this direction is the Chateau Fleckenstein. Oh no, I speak French. The Castle Fleckenstein. And here's another castle ruin, which is, or two even, which I haven't seen the last time. Very close, it said 15 minutes walking, but I think I walked 20 minutes or even 15 minutes only. But this was nearly running here up, and that's a ruin called Löwenstein, and the other one I think is Hohstein, and it's not such a good condition like Fleckenstein. There were nearly no signs, and it's relatively late now. It's 5:30 in the evening, but still nice. It must be a really nice view from there above. And yeah, let's see, I think in 10 minutes I will arrive there. And this looks here, by the way, really like the old road where 500 years ago all the people went up to the castle, which isn't the castle anymore now. And once it should have a huge mightiness, but now it's only some ruins left. But let's see how it looks. See you then upstairs. Not upstairs, up there. Wow, there's again going the trail here on the right side. But I go here straight on and let's see what's happening. You can't even see here always on the camera how steep this is. But anyway, see you then. So I arrived now, and what you can see here is a rock, and there is even the possibility to go upstairs, but first I think I went the wrong direction and I'm at the wrong part here. But anyway, it's a chance to look a little bit around, and a little bit shadow is also not so bad. And there you can see some remains of some stones. And here also, and everything is full with stones here from the castle, this here. And if you dig a little bit, there would be really a lot to find. Ooh. This was exhaustive. I shouldn't do this again here at 30 degrees Celsius. There's a bridge. And let's see what's happening here. And this is one of the two, and I forgot which one this was. I think Schönburg. And this is again sandstone here. I need to rest somewhere. Here you see some stairs. And there's even an entrance. With old structures here lying around everywhere. Old stones. But this is man-made through the stones here. Oh, this was really exhaustive, what I did here. And this was not 50 minutes, this was really 25 minutes. And it's not going further there. So, okay, let's go upstairs. And I think there's a nice view. This direction. And here you can even see some old stairs which are left. Here also something. I think this was not correct really. There are also some stairs. But okay, let's go here. That's really a nice surrounding here. Looking here all over. And then you have here this part here, this lower part. And then there's even a higher part. And it's so hot now. And I'm here with a shirt like coming from the office. But indeed I come from the office. Whew. Yeah. Oh, there's Fleckenstein. That's the Castle Fleckenstein there. This is where I started. And there I have to go back. And then here, there's my car somewhere. So there's no direct trail, I think. And I have to go around there again. But it should be only 20 minutes there. It looks further away. It's only 20 minutes. Wow. And there must be another castle. But I don't know if I visited. But it must be really close here. Somewhere. Now I feel better a little bit after I'm not climbing anymore. And let's go there upstairs, and there you should have a little better overview. And there you can also see some stairs which are left, and there's also something engraved into the rock here. And here's some very small little stairs. Must have been really impressive and complex, the system once. Not much left. So this area is completely carved out of the rock, and then it goes further up. So this is how it looks here from above, and today I have a wind protection here. I hope it helps something. Nothing left here really, and you can see nearly nothing here. Some holes, something graved into the stones, and that's it more or less. Goes deep down, and then you can see there in the distance the hills. And there is another castle, this is Fleckenstein. It's an interesting view here, because you can really see very far around here. And this is Karlsruhe, interesting. So, I'm again downstairs. And here are some remains, and is it the tunnel? No. Ah, yes. Is it the tunnel? No, it's not the tunnel where I came from. So I could have taken the tunnel to go there upstairs. It's really sad that it's in such condition here. Nice view there, and this was Castle Ruin Löwenstein, and now I go to another castle. I'm recovered now, and this is Hohenburg. Hohenburg, and this was Löwenstein, or Löwenburg, I think Löwenstein. So this is again Hohenburg. You will see it in the description. And here are some trails, and I'm recovered now. So this was really crazy, running here up. Oh, what's this? This is for horses. Who's coming with the horse here? From where? This was a really steep trail. Yeah, but okay, there's people coming with horses. And here you can also see this is completely graved out. How's it called? Engraved out of the stone here, everything. So this was perhaps someone together. And you can see the remains from the tools here everywhere in the stone structure. And the said Hohenburg, 5 minutes. And I think I have to go the way back again. And now I go a little bit slowly, but I'm not passing out here because I have nothing with me. The people are looking at me because I look like coming out of the office and have nothing with me except the camera and nothing to drink, nothing. And it's 30 degrees here outside. Wow, next time I should take water with me, but 1 hour is not so much. You can survive 3 hours without water, I think. Yeah, okay. So here's a little bit more left. Oh, it goes really high upstairs. Hohenburg. And there are some more walls in the tower left. Okay, let's see how it looks from above then. This is crazy that there are so many castles here around. Castle ruins. Everyone had a castle 500 years ago here. Again here. And horses. So, and there's a sign here. Let's see what the sign says. No fire. Yeah, nice. Ah, this looks nice. If you look at this here, that looks really nice. And what's this rock chamber? Stone stairs. Round defensive tower, Renaissance portal. 2 rock chambers with wells or cisterns. This is much more than the other one. Resist, residences, defensive wall, spiral staircase tower, outbuildings. Outbuildings. Ah, there's even some history. Hohenburg family. We controlled the Westwall in 1482. The castle originally built in the 13th century became the property of the lords of Sickingen. Franz von Sickingen had new fortifications built for the castle. Nevertheless, much of it was destroyed in 1523. And it was only rebuilt several decades later. So you can read it if you want. And yeah, I will go here upstairs now. This looks impressive. This was the old entrance. This looks really impressive. You can see the outer fortification. And here, when they went through, even in this case, there's this inner fortification. And this is now the inner part here. This looks really nice. If you look at this, the entrance here even has some carvings in the sandstone here. And so this is the entrance now. This looks really nice. This is closed. Everything full of rocks and stones here, and you can see, or perhaps you can't see, that is really everything engraved and carved here. There's even something in the walls here, and this must have been really nice somewhere. There's a well, cistern. It's now full with dirt, no water anymore. Perhaps this is original stones here. is also a nice view. Let's go which direction now? Yeah, let's first go upstairs. Oh, let's go this direction here first. And here's so much left. I didn't expect this. I expected that it's much more ruined than the other one. Ah, there's even stairs left here. Nice stairs here. And look how nice they were built here. Not even straight on as a pillar or something like this, but here, nice, I don't know how to call it. This was once a tower. There's even a fortification. Once a tower. And this is nice built here. Okay. Let's go to this here. This was also some kind of a room. This is still open. Oh, it's dark. That's a small room. And this is really small. Okay, you can hide here and you can even look out here. But what you can see is not really anything. But perhaps this was a prison also. Looks more like a prison. Oh, here. Still some remains what was engraved here into the stones. And here you have such a typical bench where you can sit on a window, but the window didn't go to the outside but to the inside. And here again you have some kind of a window, and here a window. I go now upstairs. This is really nice situated, and then you have here the old stairs left here. And they are not so much used, it seems, like in other castles. I turn it off? No. I keep recording here everything so that you can see every move, even if it's boring. But if I fall down, then you have something to see. But hopefully I'm not falling down. I'm already damaged. And these were some remains for some other stairs. I didn't know that here are so many castles. Ah, this looks nice. I'm really somehow exhausted now. What's this here? It's also some kind of stairs, but I will not climb it. And this here, stairs and the hole. Windy. Small, low, and it's the tower here. We are already nearly on top. And these stairs, by the way, are not really trustworthy. Oh, someone installed here something. Whoa. How did I get this here upstairs? Oh. It's really windy. This direction is Paris. Wow. Ja, und wir haben gesehen hier die Adler Castle, Wasigenstein, Neudahn, Altdahn, wir haben gesehen Dragon Rock, Berbertstein, und there are so many other. Wegelnburg, Lindelbrunn, Neudahn, I've been there, Lutzelart, Petit Arnsberg, Frönsburg, Fleckenstein, it's this one, oh, there's so much wind, I hope you can understand me. Hohenburg, this was this one there. Gutenberg, Gutenberg, somewhere there, can't see it. Table the orientation, the Hohenburg, 1995, oh, so old. Yeah, Freiburg, this direction. Yeah, so what you can see here is, this here is the Vosges, this is the French side, and here on the left side is the German side. So this there is Karlsruhe, and in this direction there is a, yeah, there's a gap. In the continent it's a gap, the Rhine Valley. Erlenbach, Berbertstein, yeah. So let's have a look around here, and then I will rest a little bit, and then I go home. What's this? This hole. But perhaps it was a tower once, and there are some stairs. Ah, I need something to drink, really. Ah, there's another castle here. What's this one? There are people even. There's so many castles here. Crazy. Another one. But anyway, I will relax a little bit, and then see us downstairs here or somewhere. I'm on my way downwards. I have to be careful again. It's so windy now. I have to be careful now not to fall down. So many accidents. Or only one accident. And I don't need anything more broken or even something more strange. It's a wall here. Interesting. I will go there around. And there's even, I see it now. These are stairs. So that must have been really a nice large room there. That you have nice impressive stairs going up there. Not this small ones. So let's walk this ones. And this was perhaps for Madame. There in the tower, it looks really small, but perhaps it was definitely more built around here. There's only not much left. There's a room. I know this was the well. Okay, and this here were the stairs. So you had here some impressive stairs to go up. To your chamber, and here this is missing, or perhaps it was here. Not much left. Okay. That's it now. I think I will go now backwards home. This was a short visit to two castle ruins. Ah, this is always impressive. I told you before there how this holds here for centuries here. They can even be alone then and still standing. You can see there was a floor here somewhere above. Okay. And here also stairs which have been digged. Ah, this is there, something alone still standing. This is what I mean. This bow, however you call it. And that one moved. What is this nicely built? This bow. Ah, this, or arch. It's more an arch. Yeah, okay. That's it. Let me check what's there. And there are some stairs. There are some stairs here. Yeah, this was some kind of auto building, yeah, exactly. I must be careful not to fall down here. And yeah. And this is perhaps everything here, full of stones. And here there was a wall once, which isn't anymore. But let me go here upstairs to check if I can get a better view. And now I'm inside again, nearly. I leave now, not to fall down here. The casted hand, and then one hand holding the camera. Okay, made it. Now it's time to go. The sun is still high. A very nice part here. And I don't know where I go next. But I think in some weeks we go a little bit on holiday and then we go to another country. This is from inside, you can see here the fortifications. If the enemy came inside here, you could still block the door. You know this from some movies, and then you can shoot something on it, on them. Yes. Yeah, this is still holding up for centuries, and there are also some stones left here. Everything made of sandstone. I don't know what's there inside, but anyway, to another country in 2 weeks, even 1 week now, more than 1 week, and another country. But let's see what's happening then there, and we go to camping. Am I right? No. Yeah, that's the right direction here. And then we go there to... yeah, next time, or next in 2 weeks, we go there for camping, I said. And what we are doing is some hiking trails somewhere up into the mountains. And also perhaps doing something below there somewhere, so this will be completely different now. But we said okay, let's go camping, because it's much nicer to stay outside in the evening instead on a boring hotel, and where you have even not the possibility really to cook something, and then you have to perhaps book an apartment or something like this, and so you are really flexible and go there with your equipment, and then even can do something outside, perhaps on a fire. So what we have looked for the first camp is with some fireplaces, that you can have a fireplace at your tent. This is really nice. I missed it in Western Australia. There was no possibility, or let's say there was all the possibilities you could imagine, but you wouldn't do this because it was so dry. And you would make a bushfire there with this wind. So, it's nice to have a camp with a fire outside in the evening. And let's see how it is. We organized all the equipment and we really even had some equipment. We only needed a new tent, or let's say we needed a tent. We had no tent before. And that was more or less the only thing what we needed. The rest we had already, and then we can also use it to another thing. Yeah. Okay, there are still people coming here, but the sun is still high, and it's not really anything really dramatic to do here. And I expect someone that we can travel again. What I would like to go is to Nepal. I've seen the nice videos of Nepal, and this is what I really want to see. The rest is not so interesting currently for me in the world. Nepal would be the rest, the next step, definitely what I would do. It's also relatively cheap. But as I said, 2 weeks we are in Europe, in a different country. We will see there then what's there, and go hiking, I said, camping, and do perhaps some other things, and then we also will switch the country and go to another country and do the same in Europe. So in Europe this is easily possible. Oh, what's happened with the tree there? It's really a nice view. There's again Castle Fleckenstein there. And yeah, that's what I want to say is regarding the equipment, the camping equipment, it's really needed, and we can take it. Also, we wanted even to go to in the US next year. Let's see what's happening with the US. Currently, this is really a dramatic situation, and I don't know what's happening next year, really. And we wanted to go next year in spring to the US, and perhaps let's see what's happening then and if we really do this, but would be not too expensive if you go camping there. So US is really simple normally, if there isn't any virus, because you pay the flight, you have some equipment, or you don't have any equipment, you even don't need any equipment, book a cheap car, and then you arrive there somewhere in San Francisco. This is the plan. Take your car and then you drive somewhere into the desert or somewhere else to the national parks somewhere. And I did it relatively often, but without any video, and it's absolutely no problem. You can even go there in a Walmart and buy a cheap tent, cheap other equipment, perhaps for $100, and then you are even cheaper than in a motel. And the cheapest motel would be around $50, and if you don't have any real luck, then you pay also $150. And so if you spend that $100-$200 on your camping equipment and then even leave it there or take something with you, depends, then it's much cheaper, and there's absolutely no issue. Take a car. Am I right here? Yeah. Take a car. And cars are cheap in the US. Buy in Walmart and there whatever you need. And then then you can go to a camping trip, and it's not really expensive in the US. US is really cheap to do this, and you have everywhere campgrounds in the national parks and even somewhere else. And it's also safe, especially in camps. Yeah, that's it now from my side. I talked too much perhaps, and it's too long, the video. No one around here anymore. Next time I should take something to drink with me, and I have a nice backpack, and next time I should take the backpack with me. And it's so stupid. What's this Krapenfels? And that's it from me currently, and thanks very much for watching. I know no one is watching my videos, but it can change somewhere, and I also explained somewhere that it's more for me what's happening, because somewhere I will perhaps not here anymore. I don't mean not on this world. This will hopefully be some 30-40 years still, And what I mean is perhaps to move to some other place and then I can remember. Because what I've done 20 years ago, I can't really remember anything in detail, and this is even the old videos, I can't really remember what happened in detail there. I don't watch the videos really, but perhaps I watch it in 20 years again. Yeah. Let's see what's happening in 20 years. Currently we have to survive somehow this crisis. And let's see what's happening then. Okay, thanks very much for watching. I talk too much. And see you then in the next video. Thanks and goodbye. I don't know what happened here in the woods 500 years ago, but it must have been full with roads also, and people somewhere sitting around and grabbing for money. I don't know. Everywhere. All the modern roads, or many modern roads, are old trails. Yeah, but today there are much more tourists here around, and currently there's no one around here. This is really nice. You can't hear any sound except the sounds from nature here and my voice. Yeah, and what you can see here is something here in the stones here in the middle of the woods. This is carved out of the stone here. You can see here the remains of the tools. There also the remains of the tools. So this part here is somehow carved out of the stones here, perhaps to have some kind of road going through this here. And definitely there was something here. But who knows? Whatever. But for me it looks like perhaps a gate. And this must have been looked completely different. By the way, must be really strange to say, hey guys, come on, let's build a castle somewhere here in the woods. And this in 1000 years ago, without anything. I don't know how. Oh, this is a nice part. And the rocks here. Do you see any artificial things? No. Here I don't see any artificial things currently. This looks interesting. This part there. This is really nice. But nothing artificial here. Whew. I need something to drink really. Shouldn't go next time without something to drink. I'm not 20 anymore, unfortunately. And yeah. To say, let's go, let's build a castle here. I don't know how they did this. Could they pay them really, or what, how have they done this, that they built such huge castles here in the middle of the woods somewhere? But perhaps, as I said before, this was full with roads here and they built the castle somewhere at the road. And even if it was a trail was a road nearly. If you think of 10,000 AD. This sign is crazy here because it says 30 minutes or 25 minutes here this route. This is absolutely not true. This is more difficult. It's here, a little bit off terrain, and here is a road, and this is where I went the road. And I can show you something. Where was the sign? I show you. Remember 25 minutes and 30 minutes. And I think I got this in 25 minutes, but not down. I think it was longer down because it went a little bit off-road. But let's check the sign here. This was the sign. Yeah. Now it says 45 minutes, 50 minutes. Anyway, it's really nice. And there is Castle Fleckenstein. Castle Ruin Fleckenstein. And now I think I really finish. See ya. I think this was the first one, Löwenstein, on the right side, then on the left side somewhere. There was the other one. Ah, you can even see it. Oh, is it? No. I don't know. These are only some rocks. But somewhere there, on top. And if you are fit, this is only 30 minutes. It looks more, but you don't need 1,000 euro equipment to go upstairs there. Even only simply walk there. And that's it. Okay. Now I need to go to my car. This is so quiet here and there's a biker coming. Let's see him. Let him pass here. Huh. That's crazy. But anyway, see you.